estate fertilizer, the student support group, and the Imo State University student representative, members of the PDP, their presence, people from the office, it's gentlemen of the press. I thank you. I want to state that I am overwhelmed at this request. It is like when nobody wants to be called when things are very bad to come and fix it. Everybody prefers when things are very smooth. If you remember the state that Imo State is currently, whoever is called to come and become the governor, if the person truly, truly, truly believes in true leadership, the person should be aware. Unless the person is only coming out to get the state much more indebted. Imo is highly indebted at this moment. Imo is everything but a state that is moving forward. If you are coming from Lagos State, where today I struggle to know exactly what federal project I will bring in, because most of the things you want to do and you want to attract are already being put in place. You, comparatively to Imo State, you will know that it's a Herculean task ahead. And unfortunately for us, so we've had successive leadership that I choose to see as those that are only interested in their personal development than the state development. Imo State is my state. But quite frankly, I feel so sad whenever I think of what is going on in a state that ideally should be among the top states in this country. With the resources we have, Imo State does not have any reasons to depend on federal allocation. But what would you say of people that don't create? They only deplete. When you have a state that has been managed by caterpillars and canker worms, that is what becomes of it. When you have a state that the youths have been defrauded, at some point, some were made, unemployed youths were made to buy scratch cards. I know that Imo State is one state that, if you talk about other states, in general, you have very enterprising young people that believe in education. But where do you go after being educated? The government that is supposed to provide for the young people turn around and also defraud the young people. During your remark, I have actually made it official that I do not want to be addressed as His Excellency some time ago. I am going to also set some ground rules if I am accepting this call. Starting with the first one I have said. While in office, I still do not want to be addressed as His Excellency. Secondly, my government will see a pruning down of the cost of running governance. I want to believe that everybody understands that we must have to tighten our belts. It is not easy. If we want to allow things to continue to be the way it is, there is no problem. But if we want true change, it comes at a cost. And none of us is going to go back, we're only going to move forward. What in age? You can be 25 years today and then next year you become 24 years. You can only be 26, so we are aging. And at some point, our own children will ask us what did we do at our time. At some point, we'll become grandparents and we'll either live with the choices we've made regretfully or happily. We depart this earth knowing that our legacies would outlive us positively. The future belongs to the young people like what Samson said. And I always would want to draw an analogy that a young boy visited a soothsayer, a missionary, to define what his future would look like. And the man told him that he's going to bring a dead centipede. After incantations, he drew two circles, one with a white chalk, one with a charcoal. He told the young boy, I'm going to drop this. After incantations, the dead centipede will come alive. Wherever it scrolls to, that will be your future. If it goes into the dark circle, it means your future is doomed. If it goes into the white circle, it means your future is bright. The young boy agreed, and the exercise commenced. The centipede moved towards the white. The young boy was very jubilant. Right at the edge of the white, thinking it would go in, the centipede did a detour. And with a greater speed, started walking towards the black circle. The young boy had to bend down, fit the centipede and tweet him to the white circle. At that point, the old man shouted, why did you do that? The young boy said that my future is in my hands. I will not want my future. The future of Imo State is in our hands. So, the future of Imo State is in our hands. It is us against those that want to continue to loot the treasure. Those that want to continue to keep you unemployed. Those that want to continue to make sure that our fathers and mothers do not receive their pensions. Those that want to make sure that the civil servants are not paid when they are meant to pay. Those that are geared towards ensuring that our educational system completely goes down. We either fight them, those that would make sure that there are no oxygens in the general hospitals. It's unfortunate, but it happens. We've lost loved ones over work that have been put in place by a responsible government. On one hand, we have a sacrifice to make, either to continue to receive and accept the paltry sum that they pay, the monies they use to bribe, because they